how he loves us. Oh, oh, how he loves us.
This is our 7th year doing Teen Serve Week. The need was so great that we realized that of all the years that we've ever done this, this was probably the most important year to still have Teen Serve Week. So we went forward and we started planning how we could do things to work around keeping the kids socially distant and still being able to help people. So one of the big things we did were drives, and then we did have a few places that we were able to go serve. One of the big things that we did was organizing home projects. So teens who maybe came to a couple things or maybe weren't comfortable coming or couldn't come, still were able to do curbside pickup and drop off daily in front of St. Peter. So we did that Sunday through Thursday, and they're able to make blankets for baby bundles, make scarves for Classroom Central and flashcards. There's teens making friendship bracelets to give to Boys and Girls Club. They're learning to crochet so they can make granny squares that will be made into blankets for babies that are living with the sisters and transitioning out of homelessness. Also, teens are doing storm drain markings for the city of Charlotte. So that's a project that a lot of our boys enjoy doing. So they're going around and marking the drains so that people, and that helps our teens with the creek. They're working on the creek, and so they're also working on storm drains and doing something to care for creation. And those are all things that teens can do kind of on their own time, along with mask making. We've had teens cutting out fabric, putting in elastic, and sewing all summer long.
I like coming here and doing the projects and then, you know, being able to go home and do more projects. I feel like now is everyone's in more need. Like, this is the best time to do service projects. So it was really awesome that they were still doing it, and it's really awesome that I can do it here with my friends and see my friends from church that I haven't gotten to see in months.
The benefit of this Teen Service Week is that many people in need of help have gotten extra hands to do it.
I'm a rising junior, and this week has been a little bit different, but I think it's still equally as empowering as it's been every other year, and it's really nice to help people in dire need of things, and it's really nice to find God in all things here.
The teens have been working on several different projects to help for different community service areas in the community. They're crocheting granny squares to make baby blankets for the Sisters of Charity, who home women who were homeless and just had babies. Since they have no homes, the sisters have taken them into their convent, and they are taking care of the women and rehabbing them so that they can go back out into the community with their new families. We're working on making friendship bracelets, and those will go to the Boys and Girls Club. We're not actually making the bracelets, we're making kits so that we can hand them out to the Boys and Girls Club. We'll give the little kits to the kids to make the bracelets. So we've started the bracelets here. We've had different children cut the string. Our teens today are all assembling packets so that each child could pick them up and start them. It's kind of like a loom system that they're working on. We've also collected all sorts of great stuff to go to baby bundles and to the sisters and to Boys and Girls Club this week.
I like that we get to actually see the people that we're helping and see the direct impact that we cause.
I love how we just get to interact with the community and help out with everybody. It's not just one thing. We get to do multiple things, whatever we enjoy.
I like how we're able to help lots of lives.
We kicked off the week, Teen Service Week, with the teens actually coming to campus, and Deacon Clark spoke to all the teens about Catholic social teaching and how to have a civil conversation with others on topics. Really see the light bulbs going off in the teens that when they got to the question and answer period, and the questions they asked of Deacon Clark. And also, you know, one young woman even talked about the fact that our politicians don't necessarily have civil conversations, and Deacon Clark explained that in the past, that actually did happen, but we have become a little bit more polarized. This is a really important way to start the week, I think, because it really helped the kids connect to what they were going to be doing this week, to Catholic social teaching and why it's so important that they're really participating in their Catholicism and living out the life that we were meant to live out when we read the gospel and look at our teachings.
We're making treat bags for the teachers at Druid Hills today. We have put several items in that we hope they will appreciate having in their desk, little hand sanitizer, tissues, chapsticks, some candy, some snacks, bottle of water, and we're going to add a mask for all the teachers to wear this year while they're teaching. So that's about it. The kids have written handwritten notes, and we're just attaching them to the outside of the bag.
I like making the bags for Drew and Tails teachers because there's a lot of good things for them in there.
One thing that happened early on is when we called the Boys and Girls Club, and that's an organization we usually spend 4 to 5 days every summer with, doing activities with the kids. It was brought to our attention that there were only 12 masks for 54 children, and because of that, they may not be able to have their summer activities. And these are children that really benefit from being at Boys and Girls Club during the summer. So, even though it wasn't Teen Service Week, we jumped on the wagon and the teens started cutting out templates. They cut out the masks. And then we had a call out for volunteers. Actually, the Sages and other family life ministries put out a call, and we had people that volunteered to actually sew the masks. Even before Teen Service Week started, we were able to deliver 250 masks. We delivered 100 to the Boys and Girls Club, but then we also found out that Freedom School also had a great need for masks. So even before the get-go, we delivered 250, and I'm really appreciative of the teens and all the volunteers that sewed the masks. We have a woman that from Chicago, a friend of Ted Hughes' wife, who volunteered and sent us 50 masks last week, and what a wonderful thing for someone in Chicago to do that they don't even know us. So that was one great thing for me about everyone jumping in the entire parish and participating in Teen Service Week.
Teen Service Week means helping people around us in our community that need us the most.
The Catholic faith is all about finding God in everything, so going around helping people, seeing, you know, the joy on people's faces when you can give them things and help them out, that's, you know, that's God right there.
A teen week kind of has kind of turned into something that is happening all summer long, and so even after this week, any projects that we have outstanding, teens can still work on them and bring them back when they're finished and continue all these great projects and maybe do some more just on their own. So they'll have the ideas there and the places to go to bring things.